Welcome everyone, welcome back to AQ IT Solutions. This is Ali Raza and today I'm going to introduce you one of the most running topic in the world, that is search engine optimization. And from today I'm going to start this series and I will let you know how to do SEO with your website and on your website, and how can you make your website on the top of the search engines when somebody searches for specific keywords. So I'm expecting from you people that you already have an idea and you might have heard this term SEO. Okay, so this term basically refers to the process that you can be able to bring your website on the first page of the search engines whenever somebody searches for the specific keywords on the search engines. Okay, so what I'm going to cover basically in this particular series, the first thing that we'll see, that is what are search engines and how search engines are working, and then we'll see what is indexing, what is crawling in this particular series, and then we'll learn about the searching techniques and the strategies also, and we'll also cover in this particular series the methods that optimize the search results, and we'll also cover the last thing, that is in this particular section we'll also see the importance of the user interaction on the website. Okay, so let's start. So the first thing that I'm going to convey is what is a search engine. Basically, a search engine is a place where somebody comes and find what it wants, what he wants or what she wants basically. Okay, you see the popular search engines like google.com, and you see the popular search engines like bing.com, and there are other search engines for Yahoo and other companies that are hosting those search engines. So people go on those search engines and opt for the information that they want basically. And let's say if I wanted to know the latest fashion trends in the market, so I can go on the Google search engine and I'll write the latest fashion techniques, and you'll get all the latest brands and the fashions and all the market trends that are going to be happen in this industry. So this is how you can do the search. Okay, so search engines help you to bring or to get information around the globe, around the world wide web, basically the whole internet. Okay, search engine gives you the results from around the globe. Okay, let's continue further. So what's a search engine basically? A search engine is a web-based tool, and we all know that we simply open google.com and we'll start searching. So basically that is a tool that helps us in fetching the data across the globe. Okay, the next thing that we are going to see here is the concept of crawling. What is crawling? Crawling is basically a process of that search engines can do by accepting the new websites that the public is launching nowadays, and the new web pages that are coming on the internet, the new websites that are coming on the internet. Crawling is the process that helps us to that helps search engine basically to retain the new web pages and new websites. That's it. And this crawling is done by a crawler. What is a crawler? A crawler is a program basically that looks for the new web pages and new websites and add it into the search engine database. I hope it is clear to everyone. Okay, so now the next thing that I'm going to discuss here is indexing. Basically, indexing is a process that accepts or that finds new pages and stores that new pages within the database. And now you might be confused that if the crawler is doing the same thing, the indexing technique is also doing the same thing, but what's the difference? Basically, crawler is a whole program, okay, and this whole process is known as crawling. But what is indexing? Indexing means, let's say if you have a dictionary and this dictionary has a marks, let's say if you wanted to search alpha and a word starting from P, so the dictionary is marked with the P. On that particular 1000-page dictionary, you find P very quickly because the P is marked with some color. Okay, the Z is marked with some color, the I is marked with some color, so you can be able to get on that particular point. So that is known as an index. So the websites that are coming on the Google search engine or the Bing search engine are basically indexed by that crawler that the search engines are using. I hope it is clear to everyone. I have now discussed two concepts. One is crawler and the other is indexer, and these two things are being used by search engines in order to put your website within that within the database of the search engine, so that your websites appear on the top of the page. I hope it is clear to everyone. Okay, now let's continue further. Sometimes this crawler is also known as the spider bot, and or you can also say it's spider because it is basically referencing the net or the web throughout the scenario of the World Wide Web. Simple. Now let's continue further. We have a crawler for Google that is known as Google bot, and with the help of that crawler you can be able to add your website within that crawler, and then what will happen, the website will start appearing on the upcoming pages or on the starting pages of the search. I hope it is clear to everyone. So how can you add your website to a Google crawler or the Google bot? It's very simple. You type on the Google search engine, let's say Google Webmaster Tools. Okay, so when you write on the search engine Google Webmaster Tools, you will be able to, you will be redirected to the Google Webmaster Engine, and where you, and there you can add your particular website. Okay, so let me show you how do you do this. On the web. That's it. All right, guys. So we have Chrome browser open already, and here you have to write Google Webmaster. This is the place where you can add your website. In order to track your website when you search your website on any search engine, that is Google right now in this case. So this is the website, guys. Click on the search console, and then you have to sign in. But right now, because I have already signed in from my account, you can see, so it asks you your Gmail ID and password, so you have to provide this. Okay, now you are seeing, looking at these two things. This is the newer way to add your website, and this is an older way. So you wish to use any of the two. So in this case, I'm using this one. Okay, the newer one, because it contains all the subdomains as well. I have a domain with the name, let's say bunyads.com. I have to give my domain to them, and it requires the DNS verification, while this does not require DNS verification, the older one. Okay, now if you have any DNS provider, who is the DNS provider? Basically your hoster, on which you have the platform where you have hosted your website. Maybe it can be any, or it can be any of the popular domain hosters. You can see in this case I have godaddy.com, but if you have any DNS provider, so what you have to do, you have to sign into your cPanel on your website, okay, and then copy and paste this code in the DNS configuration that you find on your cPanel. Okay, if you do not find your DNS configuration on your cPanel, then contact your hosting provider. He will let you know where is the DNS configuration, and then you will copy this code and paste that there, and then click on the verify button. Simple. Okay, but if you have a popular DNS provider, let's say in this case I have godaddy.com, so it's worldwide, so you don't need to copy and paste some code on the cPanel. You simply start verification and then click here. You can also verify later also. Now a new link is now opening in front of us. All right, guys, so you can see I'm now logged in into my GoDaddy account, and here I have given my credentials, that is username and password. In your case, you provide your username and password and come inside. Okay, if you have other than GoDaddy domain hoster, so you can use your that cPanel in order to come inside. But here we have this. Now it's asking me to please authorize this. Yes, authorize it. Okay, so it is, you can see it is loading. Now you are get back to your Google search console and checking DNS records, and after this process will complete, you will come inside the search console and your website will be successfully added within the Google search console. I hope it is clear to everyone. All right, guys, so you can see the ownership is now verified, and to stay verified, don't remove the DNS records. Okay, so now you can click on done. Simple. That's it. After this, you can continue on this URL, and you can perform different search operations, like if you come here and write google.com, okay, and let us find Bunyads. Do we have that or not? So you can see there are different websites coming, but still the Bunyads website is on the first page. Okay, and right now we haven't specified some keywords. Let's say property, sell, purchase. If I write here something like this, oh wait a minute, spelling mistake. Let me write here property sell purchase, now it's fine. So you can see there are so many other websites, but we do not find the bunyads.com because it's a property website, but you are not seeing this bunyads on the first page. Why? Because I haven't made those keywords on that particular website. Okay, so keywords are of very much importance, but when you write here bunyads, if you see, the Google search engine gives you the website on the first page after this, and you can see the YouTube videos for bunyads are also appearing here. Simple. I hope it is clear to everyone. So this, why this is coming here? This is coming because you have just added your website here at this particular point, Google Search Console. I hope it is clear to everyone. Now you can specify the property. Let's go here for bunyads.com, and you can see welcome to your new domain property, and here you can start this scenario, and you can see a whole dashboard where you can be able to find the performance, the coverage of your domain, the enhancements, everything. Okay, so this search console gives you the whole A to Z information about what is going to be happen. Now the next important thing that we must understand are the sitemaps. Whenever you are going to apply SEO on your website, you have to upload your sitemap on your search engine online portal. Okay, because sitemap is the map that helps search engines to give appropriate pages to the users when they search the desired content. Let's say if somebody searches for the garage rent or sale, okay, so your website might have garage pages and your website might have bungalow pages or apartment pages. So if somebody searches for that apartment or somebody searches for that bungalows or some other flats, so those specific pages can be opted or can be fetched out from the search engine database if you uploaded the sitemap of that website. So how a sitemap can be created, that's another topic, but I will let you know that you can create an XML file and create tags for your sitemap and upload it here as well. So we'll cover it later on, but for the sake of knowledge, we should know that what is going to be happen. Okay, there are other engines, like let me write here Bing Webmaster, and in this you can see the webmaster tools for Bing are available, and you can add your website on Bing as well. In order, let's say we have different categories of users. Somebody is using Google or somebody is using Bing for their search engines, so you can use that. Okay, so let me write here my ID and password so that it can show me my dashboard. All right, so first thing, that is the email address. Okay, and then we have to enter the password. All right guys, so you can see I have this Bing Webmaster. I have logged in here with my ID and password, and in this you can see I have already added one website. If I click on this, I will go to the dashboard and I'll see the statistics of this website. That's my personal blog, but it's a template. Don't worry about that. You can visit this website and you can see that, and that's a template. It is not the actual picture. Now one more thing that I must mention here is that you can add your different websites on this particular you can see the add website URL. So you can write here bunyads.com. okay, but before going on, before adding this, let us open bing.com and see what is happening. If I write here bunyads, let's see what will be the results. Okay, wait a minute, that's B-U-N and Y-A-D-S, that's the name. You can see the search engines are now getting the things. You can see bunyads, and there are other websites as well, but your website is coming on the top, though it will give you more appropriate results if you directly write here or if you add your website within this. So your web engine or your web search engine will have it in its database. I hope it is clear to everyone. Okay, so this is the website that is being loaded. So I hope it is clear to everyone. Let's add it. Click add, and now it will ask you certain settings and details. Okay, do you want to add a sitemap? Okay, so that's the thing that I was discussing right now. And now right now I'm skipping this and click add. Alright guys, so you can see there are so many options just like we have seen on Google Webmaster tool. So we have to verify it on the GoDaddy, and we can download this file and put it on the bunyads.com cPanel in the file explorer, and then we can also verify, and we can also copy and paste the meta tags in order to make the search engines more appropriate. I hope it is clear to everyone. So these all are the details, guys. You can be able to follow these steps and add your website to the webmaster. So I'm stopping here at this particular point. The summary of this whole lecture is that we have discussed what is search engine and what is SEO, and how can you add your website to Google webmaster tools, and how can you add your website to the Bing webmaster tools. So try this by yourself if you have a live hosting website. So try up till now, and then in the next lecture we'll cover the further more details, how can you search and what are the different searching techniques. Okay, so that's all for today. If you don't understand anything, please do write me. Thank you so much. Take care. Allah Hafiz.